Now, to do pants, this is going to be done a little differently. Because you're going to start at the waistband. You're going to do the waistband. Now, here's the fold line for that. And then this. Now, you may or may not want to do rib. It's up to you. And then you have the crotch area here that you need to increase, and then the leg. But I want to show you something on the scale ruler here. Now, I don't have the rulers, scale rules that come for the pants. It has a zero in the middle. But I could take it, and I'm going to use 45 as the center zero. So the 4 over here, which would have been normally 40, that's going to be left 5, left 15, left 25. And then going the other side is the right side. So I just have to, in my mind, or make a little note of what I'm doing here. So if that's 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 23... 5, 10, 15, 16, 17. So I got left 23 to right 17 that I will cast on for the pants. That's doing the same size that I did before. Then again, as you get going, you're going to be increasing. And that's all you have to do is just keep an eye on the line here. And here, on the crotch, this is where I'm going to be increasing. So now I've got 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 26, 27, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. So it's going to be a little off on both sides. It's not going to be an exact thing. If you have the scale ruler that has the zero in the middle, then you just line it up with that center line here is all. And then you're going to see what numbers that's going to reflect to your machine. To make your own pattern to go in the Knit Radar, I had taken a sewing pattern and I scanned it, made a copy of it on my machine so it's the same size. And of course I had it taped it together in the three pieces. But I only need half of it. So I folded it in half. I tape down the back side of that to hold that in place. I take my other piece of paper and tape that down. Now, it's really good to have one of these pantographs. Now, there are ways that you can make your own. And what I'm doing is I'm reducing this. I'm going to make this half size, which is what I need for my Knit Radar. Because this ain't going down, holding down for me, I had to come on this side. But I'm going to take this point here, and I'm going to go around the pattern piece. And the pen or pencil is drawing what I need. Now it's kind of faint, but I could see it myself. So what I'm going to do is take a pen and I'm going to go over these lines. Now the straight line here is fine. I could just go up. And there I have it. So now I am going to cut this out and get this on a piece of paper to put inside my Knit Radar. So next, using my quilting cutting board and my quilter's ruler and the rotary cutter, I no longer need this pattern here, so I can put that off to the side. But I measured the paper that came in the Knit Radar and it was 8 1/4 inches wide. So I tried squaring this up. Evidently I crossed somewhere. One side is off a little. Actually, the widest point is 8 1/8, so I'm off a little bit on the width. But that's no big deal. Then I took the two ends and made sure I lined up one side here, and I drew the line there so that I could line it up once I got it on the knit radar. Then I took my ruler again, and I went in 1/4 inch from the side and drew that line. Then I took the pattern, put it in place, held it down, traced around it. Now this is ready to go into the knit radar for me to knit up. So this was newborn diaper cover. Okay, I was able to come across the mid-gauge ruler here need for measuring your swatch. So what you do is you're going to cast on 50 stitches, so 25 each side. Do about 10 rows of your main yarn. Of course, you want to figure out what tension dial setting you like. Then do 2 rows of contrast and color. Then you're going to do 15 rows and then set your contrast and color so we can measure the stitches later. And what you do is you just take a little piece of contrast and color yarn, bring that needle 16 on both sides out, and then hand knit that back, and then knit 15 more rows, 2 more rows of contrast and color, 10 rows of the main color. And then take it off the machine, let it rest, and then we'll measure to see what we get. So as I measure my stitches per inch, I come up with 20, 21, 22 stitches per inch. And then when I do the rows, I get 41 rows for the 4 inches, I'm sorry, not the inch. So I need to get those set up on my knit radar. So that was 22 and 41. So I've got my 22 stitches per 4 inches roller set up in my radar. And then I did set the row counter to 40. Now I'm still within that 30 to 60, so I just leave that as it is. So as I look at my pattern, and I have this set right on the bottom line here, it looks like it's telling me to cast on 3 stitches, but I'm going to start out with 5, and that's on both sides, so I'm going to be casting on 10 stitches to begin with. Then I'm going to be casting on increasing to a certain point, and then I'm going to be decreasing. That should only be decreasing and not binding off. And then increasing again, and then when I get to the top, just do a bind off. I was hoping to do this with the full needle rib, but it's not going to work out with all these extra casting on, the extra stitches on the bottom here. So what I'm going to have to do at the end of this is I will probably crochet around the outside edge of the finished garment or do a machine knit trim to hold that flat is all. Now I pinned out the baby diaper cover so that you could see how it looks. Of course, it's this little thing here is a little bit too small for me to pin it all. But when I take the original pattern and I put it on here, of course this is smaller. If you remember, I had set my radar for 40 rows for 4 inches instead of 41 rows. So that right there made a little bit of a difference. Maybe I measured my gauge wrong. But in this case, what I would do is crochet around the edge of this, and then I would, on the front part here, I would crochet like little buttonholes and then put buttons on the top. The original pattern did call for putting elastic in the front here, or maybe it was the back. No, it's the front. So you could sew some elastic in there to help draw it up. But this will fit somebody. So that's a good thing with some things, even though they come out larger than expected or smaller than expected. I'm sure you're going to find somebody it'll fit.